Unless you've been living under a rock or zipping around on an electric scooter, you would have noticed fuel prices are again skyrocketing.
Petrol prices are disgusting.
To fill my tank costs over $70.
Used to be about $50, but now definitely $80 to $90.
Oh, I think it was like $110 last week.
I don't drive anymore because of them.
Despite former PM Scott Morrison's pre-election excise sweetener,
halving the petrol tax,
Aussie motorists are back under the pump. Over the past week, the average cost per litre has risen just over 14 cents, the third biggest price hike on record. Capital cities are looking at more than $2 a litre. It's even higher in the regions, and there's no end in sight.
We simply do not know where the average price could go. It has now become almost impossible to predict what's going to happen in the next 24 hours.
The accelerating cost, thanks to the global oil supply crisis due to the war in Ukraine, the pandemic, mainly China's zero COVID policy, which continues to see most of the country, therefore ports, in lockdown, and most recently, a fire at a large oil refinery in South Korea, one of our largest suppliers.
The markets reacted with a $10 jump per barrel in the price. Such is the volatility of world oil prices in 2022. It is impossible to predict what they're going to do from one day to the next, and that doesn't look like anything's going to change in the short term.
Now, the Albanese government's being urged to extend the excise break beyond the end of September.
Now, I've tried to be pretty upfront with people and say it would be difficult for us to extend that forever. It's a very expensive bit of cost of living relief. We've got to weigh up and work out what are the best things that we can do that get the best bang for buck from any money that we might spend out of the budget.
We hope to see relief. But the reality that we face in Australia is we have no control over the factors that determine petrol prices.
So with no respite in sight, how much longer can Australians keep on trucking?
It is very tough, especially when you're out there trying to make a living.
It's just general, the whole situation, it stinks.
Well, economist Angela Jackson is here to tell us what else is in store. Hopefully it's not all bad news, Angela. Just how high can we expect these prices to go?
Oh, look, it's anyone's guess at the moment, unfortunately. We've obviously seen petrol prices going up significantly over the last 12, 18 months. They did drop for a while there, down to $1.60, and I think we all thought, oh, it's over, but now they're back on the rise again. Hopefully they won't peak as high as they were back in March due to that excise cut that the government introduced in the budget, but we do expect to see oil prices higher and quite volatile for the period ahead.
Well, given that the oil prices are going to remain volatile, how long can we expect these high prices to continue for?
So, look, I can't give you that answer, unfortunately. What we can see is looking forward is that these higher prices are likely to last at least 18 months, 2 years ahead, and potentially longer into the future.
Not much time to celebrate the election win for Labor, Angela. How much pressure does this put on the Albanese government to extend Scott Morrison's fuel excise cut?
Oh, look, it is challenging times, Pete. There's no doubt about that. Like high inflation and managing it and managing that sort of transition back to, you know, that inflation between the 2 to 3% range, it is tough, and it's tough in terms of the economy. I think in terms of extending that cut, it's probably not the best way to alleviate the pressure of higher prices across the board for households. It's very broad-based. That is, all households benefit from it, both the rich and poor households. And what I think they really need to be looking for, I think, come September, is more targeted approaches. We've seen prices rising significantly in the last 12 months. They're probably going to keep rising in the medium term. So really thinking about those households that have been impacted the most, and that's low-income households, households on fixed incomes who really don't have the disposable income available to necessarily absorb these price rises that we're seeing across the board.
Angela, we're talking about petrol at the pump, but it's surely much bigger than that because so much relies on oil. Like, if the prices stay high like this, what's the effect on a whole lot of other stuff that we buy?
Exactly, Waleed. So the price of oil does, it permeates the entire economy, and that's part of the problem. So yes, you know, it is just oil and it is just at the pump and that's what we see, but of course it goes into manufacturing more broadly. It goes into transport costs, so, you know, the price of food at the supermarket's impacted. So what we see is it does really flow through the economy, and that's one of the reasons why, you know, higher oil prices and rising oil prices is such an economic risk.
Ah, it's when the good news is even bad news. Angela Jackson, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.